People should be asked to pay for it. There has to be a strong political will.
Okay.
Can I make a point, sir?
Yeah. Quick point.
Yeah, just one point. I think there is a tendency of state utilities to function as a trading now company. They see an opportunity and they start trading. So your responsibility is to provide this thing and not really trade. I mean, that aspect I'm seeing growing.
No, but they can't be doing on a non-commercial basis.
No, phone commercial. I mean, that's the issue of affordability.
To supply, but the responsibility also to be commercially healthy.
No, fine. But then we have to see the affordability, yeah, how it is. There are ways to do that.
Okay, so I mean, consensus around this is that notwithstanding what Central City Authority has, even at draft stage, said so, you all feel that at 315,000 megawatt, not only we are not surplus, we have a long way to go, because that makes it only 1100 kilowatt hour per head per year. That's the fact. You see, where it goes counter to this whole thing is that those people who have invested in generation, you are investing in transmission, and if they don't utilize their capacity beyond 60%, the overall plant load factor of the country has gone to about less than 60%. And that includes about 80% or so of NTPC. So that means there are others who may be struggling at something like 50, 55. So for them it becomes a calculator. Banks have started becoming scared. CA may say this or that, but with this type of a situation, even banks feel that if they give you loan, whether their loan will be repaid. So I think that brings us to the second supplementary issue, and quickly I will ask you. Firstly, any one of you in the audience,
quick point.
Any one of the in the audience has a contrary view, means you really think power has become surplus. And I am asking only those people who think power has become surplus. Nobody? That means we still need to add capacity? Okay. Well, I will come back to you. Okay, Chaturvedi ji, bataiye. Very quick one.
Sir, Rajiv Sharma ji said that there has to be a mechanism with the regulators for the payment systems.
Ajay, I forgot you have been a regulator also.
Sir, yes. having been a regulator myself, you would be amazed to know, sir, that each regulator in every state, they show their tariff orders to Chief Minister first before giving the final judgment. Yeah.
Okay, so fine. We will come to...
Can I make one point?
Yeah. Quick point.
I think that we are caught up with the demand and supply. Two questions are important: affordability and economic and environmentally safe power.
Okay.
Please understand this point. Why I make this kind of point? That affordability is extremely important. And I think that you can't go on. The question which you raised, globally I am trying to find out, for example, that demand, there are 2 billion people globally, and they would be without power up to 2020. Now, when we talk about the country, do we also talk about the globe? So that's why the question which you raised, corporate governance issue, we don't predict our future.
Correct.
That's why looking beyond is the major crux of the business, and that doesn't happen in most of the companies. I must also tell you, I'm talking on the basis of my experience, at least about working on 50 boards, whether it happens or it doesn't happen.
So thanks, Dr. Singh, for giving a better phrase. The first part of our initial comment I had concluded saying that institutionalized arrangement to predict change over a period of next 5 years and prepare for this, maybe I may agree or disagree, but I can grant that NTPC should be given that, they have that. I have a doubt, but okay. But that is only one. So that should become one of the important responsibilities of HR. So that was the conclusion of the first round. Then the second round we had this, we have concluded unanimously almost that we have not reached surplus, we have a long way to go. Of course, rest of the things will follow, how we economize, etc., how we manage. quick round, only one or two suggestions each one of you in 1 minute. How do we then increase consumption? This goes counter to decreasing consumption by being energy efficient. Like if I use conventional bulb, then I was using 60 watt, then we shifted to the CFL. CFL gives you 60 watt at 14 watt, and your LED gives you same 60 watt effect at maybe 4 or 5 watt. So over a period of 5 years, 6 years, from 60 watt to 14 watt to 5 watt. So 5 is 1/12 of 60. So far as lighting is concerned, we also introduced in the Bureau of Energy Efficiency, energy efficient air conditioner, energy efficient refrigerator. So there is a huge, and rightly so, huge mission to be energy efficient without sacrificing your requirement. That is one. And yet, we also have to increase our capacity. And how do we increase consumption? Couple of suggestions from each one of you, starting from maybe you. Very brief.
Yeah. First and foremost, I will say that if we have to increase the consumption, the electricity has to be, as we mentioned, affordable, reliable and sustainable. So if it becomes reliable or sustainable, then we have to bring the industry users who are using their own captive power plant to the grid connection. That's the most important thing. For that, tariff structure may also have to undergo change. In addition to that, the captive power projects, the DG, there are so many DG sets users. Those DG sets users also have to be converted into the grid users. Second thing is electrical, what you call mobility. Electric mobility is going to be the key for the future electricity consumption. Lot of work is being done in view of the shortage of time. I'd not like to spend time on that. Third is the railways. Railway is going to be the major consumer of electricity. I think time has come that we go away with the, what you call, diesel based locomotive and convert that to the electric locomotives also. It will have twin objective. One is definitely fossil fuel will not be used there. Second thing, electricity consumption will increase.
Balan, two suggestions to increase consumption and demand. You can give only one if you want.
One, I would suggest distributed power generation. And number two, pooling of power.
Okay. Mr. Jha.
Sir, in addition to that, these are the methods.
Yeah, additional only. Yes.
In addition, what is happening, sir? What is the demand? Today we are saying this is the demand purchased by the distribution company. It is not the demand of the country. The distribution company purchases the less power. Why they are purchasing the less power? Because they don't have the institution to supply the power. I'm just giving the one example. Few days back, I was in my village. Every house is getting the fixed tariff of 400 rupees per month, whether house is locked or whether you are running with so many ACs. Means there is no institution. That's why they are in loss. And they are in loss, that's why they are not purchasing. That's why we have to change the institutionalization of the distribution company. This is the only solution, what I feel.
Rajiv, you know, Rajiv has seen all. Transmission, Ministry, REC, PFC, CA. I think, yeah, he's one man who has gone across. So his experience of all good and bad. Okay.
Sir, we should arrange, have camps in the villages for giving connections to APL households. So it will increase consumption in rural areas. And number two, industrial units, large, for many years we have not seen big ticket industrial unit for matter, aluminium, steel, whatever it is, whatever may be the international market, but not large projects in the metal sector has not been
good. Two or three comments from any one of you, but just say, how do we increase consumption and demand? Mm-hmm. Just one-liner.
Sir, one-liner. Yeah. Follow the telecom model. Nobody has a problem there of, telephones these days. I think same way, give connection to everybody, have smart meters so that remote switch on and switch off is possible if they don't pay.
Delhi mein aap kariye to aap to Tata Power.
This has been done, sir.
कर दिया.
दिस इज ऑलरेडी देयर. दिल्ली इज 24/7, सो दिल्ली इज आई थिंक आइसोलेटेड. वी कैन नॉट टेक द सेम एग्जांपल.
एनी अदर सजेशन? एनी एचआर पर्सन गिविंग सजेशन? आई आल्सो वांट टू सी द कैपेबिलिटी एनहांसमेंट, कॉम्पिटेंस एनहांसमेंट विद इन एचआर. इट विल बी ग्रेट इफ एचआर पीपल वेयर ऑल्सो टू मेक सम सजेशन ऑन कॉम्प्लेक्स टेक्निकल एंड फाइनेंशियल इशूज.
थैंक यू सर फॉर गिविंग अस दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी टू द एचआर फ्रेटर्निटी. In fact, as has been rightly quoted, and even at the cost of reputation, that the present demand or per capita consumption is certainly almost one third of the global level, if you see. And if the economy has to grow, and energy being the major prime mover for the economy and driver for the economy, I think we cannot remain insulated from these pressures and pushes of this market. So therefore, the energy demand also has to grow. This is fundamental. Now, with the present scenario that we see is that the growth is struck somewhere within hardly 2-3%, which is a superficial growth, largely being shaped by the restrictions and inaffordability of the DISCOMs to buy more and more power. But that doesn't mean that the end consumer is not having appetite for this power. So one of the method to do it is to reach out to those rural areas and provide access of electricity to those people, as Mr. Rajiv Sharmaji was explaining, that more than 5.5 crore populations of Indian nation are without access to the power, quality power. So therefore, those distributed off-grid kind of solutions, more with renewable inputs, could be one of the methods to improve this demand, which may not see and come through a conventional way.
Okay, so that means, okay, last comment, one line.
Okay, I think a lot of this demand dilemma that we are facing today is also due to the fiscal indiscipline in the DISCOMs that has happened over so many years. One of the quick things that can be experimented in some of the places is, can we go for a franchisee model where entrepreneurs take up small areas and through a very good fiscal discipline, that commercial, unless commercial viability is there, demand will not grow okay. in the primary sector.
Okay. So that means, so far as this issue is concerned.
Can I raise one question for
you,
sir?
Question, we want answer.
Sir, my question, sir.
Okay.
Why not we should discuss about, you go to Spain, 97% solar power.
No, you have to repeat on the mic.
You go to Spain, 37% solar power. You go to France, about more than 50% actually nuclear energy. Now it's high time that we should discuss whatever we are going to doing, whether we would be allowed to do it or not globally.
Yeah.
And nobody is asking that questions. So we are caught up with the demand and supply. But my point is, what kind of power?
That's another issue.
That's a big issue. I hope that since all the persons are sitting here, if they can focus on that and what we have done and what we should do, that's a very important question.
That's very valid. So see, this point was that have we become surplus? Answer was no. We have to create more capacity. That means our per capita consumption has to grow far beyond 1100 kilowatt hour per year. Then the tail supplementary issue was, how do we then generate demand? There is a number of suggestions have come. So long as the distribution is managed in the manner it is managed, and the buyer of Jha made, also Rajiv made, buyer of power is distribution company, which thinks, and not only thinks, it is true, that the more it buys, the more it loses. So it doesn't buy. So it doesn't go to somebody else. So he resorts to diesel generator. So he pays more. But mindset of people also has to change. Why is it that our consumers in rural area as well as in urban area, they are not prepared to pay 5 rupees a unit to a distribution company, but they don't crib if they pay 15 rupees a unit to a diesel generator?
So may I answer that question?
Who?
Yeah. Actually, sir, people get used to comforts. Now, with the mobile, what has happened is that people got used to that and so they are willing to pay for that. Whereas our power has not reached them yet, so they have not got used to the comforts. The idea is to make them to get addicted to it and they automatically start drawing it.
And the last question that I will ask on this issue, it is good that the HR senior most people of two leading organizations, NTPC and Power Grid are there. Can there be an initiative led by NTPC and Power Grid? That doesn't mean you will do all the work. I am saying an initiative to enhance demand. Because future of both of you and many others like you, but the smaller sizes, is closely dependent on this issue. When people are raising this question, your financer will not find fund, your share market price will go down, because that feeling is coming that power sector growth is stagnant in terms of demand and consumption. Can there be an initiative led by NTPC and Power Grid on how to enhance consumption and demand, at the same time be energy efficient? Boliye.
I think, sir, we'll be able to do
then
it.
Then we will first HR people should talk. Then we will talk to Guru.
Yeah.
One direct chairman is already here.
Yeah.
I think you have rightly said, sir, the initiative and lead has to be taken, and the buzzword and the only mantra would be the collaboration. Because each organization has its own core competencies, we need to collaborate those core competencies and come up with a business model which can address these issues. And I think sooner we need to start this beginning. And already there are some forums which are available where we can make a headway and take it forward.
So correct. Till now, we have taken many conclusions we have drawn, but two action conclusions. One action conclusion for HR is institutionalized arrangement for predicting change over next 5 years. Another action conclusion is an initiative led by NTPC, Power Grid, maybe even VHL can combine, on how to enhance. There will be other partners who will join you, but so these two action conclusions. Let me take on to the third point. I think addressing the climate change concerns, also the point Dr. Pritam Singh just now raised, what power, coal power, other power, etc., etc. So the fuel diversification, somehow it is becoming inevitable now that our dependence on coal in terms of proportion will have to drastically reduce in terms of proportion. And in a big way, you are going to embrace, you have already embraced, but the pace may become even faster, the renewables, whether it is wind or solar. What is giving credence and acceptability to this is the fast change in the prices of solar. Just 4 years back, solar was 15 rupees a unit, now it is 3 rupees a unit. Workability being doubted, etc., etc., but that is a different part. Maybe it may not be 3, it may be 350, but it is in that range. But renewables bring with this a number of other issues. I would start comment from Mr. Jha that with the fast changing contribution from renewables, more so in from solar, are you well geared in terms of time to cope with which point that Rajiv made and others have made, even Mr. Pujari made that point? How do we also ensure smooth operation of grid compatible with this size of expansion that we are talking?
There is no doubt, sir. The renewable energy giving a lot of challenges. How to integrate it, because it has the such nature, the intermittency, variability, and not having supply for 24 hours. These are the major changes. And in power sector, in transmission sector, that these challenges comes in two way, which people may understand. It is very easy to understand that if it goes up, some power is to substitute it, but there is some stability issue is also there. And that's why integration of the grid is very important. And number of action has been taken. Time will say that how much successful we will be, but
you should not say.
Just a second, I'm saying, sir. Why I mentioned that time? Because the major, there are two challenges. One is the green energy has to be, renewable energy has to be integrated very strongly so that any variation in the renewable energy should be sustained by the entire grid, because a small body cannot sustain it. A second challenge was skewed the necessary transmission system in the gestation period of solar. And that's why we have planned in advance, 2 years in plan, the GE energy corridors. In fact, we are developing a GE energy corridor. If you see the GE energy characteristic of the GE energy corridors, it starts from the Gujarat, Bhuj, Kutch area. It is going through the Banaskanta, Bikaner, Ajmer, then Moga. All through that, this is the line. Only the generation will come and hook it. It will be in advance. That's why the integration, transmission integration is not an issue. Now, second is how to maintain the stability. One is very important, that today grid may not sustain so much variability. We have done the studies. We thought that there is a requirement of shock absorber. If something comes, that's how we plan a new technology that is called a STATCOM, which will be there, and 14 STATCOM are under construction. By the time they will come, it will be under. Third is, what is how to control them. Because forecasting, balancing, etc. is very important thing. We have planned 11 number of REMC all over the country to do that. Why I mention that time will say? Because of the balancing. Means tomorrow, if demand growth will be the same way, we are just adding the renewable energy, and lot of thermal is already back up, then maybe balancing not an issue. If demand also pick up, and we are not adding conventional energy much, then some balancing power has to come up.
So that means there is a need to sort of further
addition of
evaluate this. We might take steps, that initiative that I suggested for consideration of NTPC and Power Grid, how to increase demand. But maybe it might not be as optimistic as we talk. So demand will not pick up that fast. Solar will pick up fast. Thermal is getting back down. Its limit is to back down. So it, and then transmission connectivity, those are the issues. So I think